I'm presenting data on an exploratory analysis of patient-reported outcomes from a randomized phase two trial known as P2001. This was a randomized phase two study of pevonedistat, which is a first-in-class NAD8 activating enzyme inhibitor, plus azacitidine versus azacitidine alone in patients with higher-risk myelodysplastic syndrome, MDS, chronic myelomonocytic leukemia, CMML, or low blast AML. Now, low blast AML for this study was defined as those with untreated AML with bone marrow blast percentages between 20 and 30%. So it was a distinct subgroup of AML who were eligible for this study. And to give clarity and background on this randomized phase two clinical trial known as P2001, 120 patients were randomized between the combination pevonedistat plus azacitidine versus azacitidine alone in all three different cohorts, MDS, CMML, and low blast AML. And the study was overall powered to show an event-free survival advantage and then subsequently changed to an overall survival advantage between the combination and azacitidine. We reported results from an exploratory analysis assessing patient-reported outcomes within this patient population. And patient-reported outcomes is critically important to assess in clinical trials in MDS and AML patients, particularly as these patients have a lot of symptom burden. Many have symptoms that can impact their quality of life. And there's really limited data of patient-reported outcomes in the context of these disease subgroups. We utilized a widespread cancer-specific patient-reported outcome instrument known as the EORTC QLQ C30 score in the context of this study. And we were mainly interested in four domains of patient-reported outcomes: physical function, global health status or quality of life, fatigue, and dyspnea. Some of the exploratory endpoints that we assessed on this study were whether there were any differences in patient-reported outcomes between the combination treatment and azacitidine over time, and whether there are changes in patient-reported outcomes in those who achieve response versus those without a response. Overall, we did not see any significant differences between both treatment arms, the combination and azacitidine alone, in patient-reported outcomes over time in all four of the metrics that we studied. And this suggests that the addition of pevonedistat to azacitidine does not significantly impact patient-reported outcomes or quality of life measures in patients with MDS, CMML, and AML. Notably, when we looked at complete remission rates in those with the higher risk MDS and CMML subgroups, comparing both treatment arms together, we noticed a non-significant trend, an improvement in patient-reported outcomes in those who achieved a complete remission versus those that did not. And again, this was not statistically significant, but suggests that achieving complete remission is important for this disease subgroup, not only from an efficacy standpoint, but from a patient-reported outcome quality of life standpoint. And lastly, one of the other interesting analyses from this is that when we looked at MDS patients who, MDS and CMML patients who then progressed or transformed to AML in the context of this study, there was a general trend to worsening of patient-reported outcome scores once those patients progressed and transformed to AML. So we think patient-reported outcomes is critically important to integrate into these clinical trials to assess how these agents are impacting patients' quality of life and achievement of complete remission based on the results of this study is critically important, not only from an efficacy standpoint, but from a quality of life standpoint. And overall, there did not appear to be any significant change in patient-reported outcomes with the addition of pevonedistat to azacitidine in this cohort. Additional analyses are planned, but I think these results are notable.